we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section Linear Algebra. And the problem is based on a anti-diagonal matrix and its eigenvalues of an even order. And this question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is a 100 by 100 matrix capital A is equal to Aij is such that Aij is equal to I if I plus j is equal to 101 and Aij is equal to 0 otherwise. Which of the following statements are true about the matrix A? And the four options are given. Option 1, A is similar to a diagonal matrix over R. Option 2, A is not similar to a diagonal matrix over R, over C, the set of complex numbers. Option 3, one of the eigenvalues of A is 10. Option 4, none of the real eigenvalues of A exceeds 51. Now, we now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We are given A is a 100 by 100 matrix and it is a real matrix Aij 100 by 100 where Aij is equal to I if I plus j is 101 and Aij is equal to 0 otherwise. Let's see how this will look like. Now, the first row and the 100th column, I is 1, j is 100, then Aij will be I, that is Aij is 1, and the remaining elements are all 0. And in the second row, I is equal to 2, j is equal to 99, that means the second row and 99th column element, there Aij is I is 2 and the remaining are all 0. Like that it will be like this. And the entries are there on the anti-diagonal and the remaining elements are all 0. Such a matrix is called an anti-diagonal matrix of order 100. And we note down that what is the entry at the 50th row and 50th column. The 50th row, 50th column is, if you make addition, 50 plus 50, I plus j is 100, which is not 101, therefore the value is 0. So the 50th row, 50th column element is 0, and thereby all the elements on the diagonal, on the main diagonal, are all 0. Therefore, the trace of A is equal to 0. Now, we want to compute the eigenvalues of A and then get into the options. And for that, what we have done is, we have first taken A square. So, we have taken A into A. Now, multiply first row by first column. If you multiply, you will get 1 into 100. That is the first row, first column element. After multiplication, you will get 1 into 100. And the second row, first column, if you multiply, you will get 0. And any row with first column except the first row, you will get 0. And if you multiply the second row with the second column, you will get 2 into 99. That is 2 element is 2 into 99 and the remaining are all 0. So like that you will go on getting. That means along the diagonal you will find 1 into 100, 99 into 2 and so on so forth. How the after multiplication it will look like. So diagonal entry 1 into 100, 2 into 99 and so on so forth. At the 50th row and 51 column, that is surviving element, and 51 row, 50th column, and 99th row and into 2, 99th row into 2. So this is actually first row multiplied by first column. First row, first column is 1 into 100. Second row, second column, 2 into 99. Second row, second column. This is 50th row, 50th column. 51st row, 51st column. 99th row, 99th column multiplied by 100th row multiplied by 100th column. So this is the answer for A square. So what do you observe? This is a diagonal matrix, and if you want the eigenvalues of a diagonal matrix, the diagonal entries are the eigenvalues of a diagonal matrix. So we observe A square is a diagonal matrix, and hence the eigenvalues of A square are 1 into 100, 2 into 99, 3 into 98, 50 into 51. Then afterwards, these 51 into 50 is already there, and 99 into 2 is 2 into 99, 100 into 1 is 1 into 100 is there. That means they are repeated twice. So you got the 50 distinct eigenvalues, but they are repeated twice. Now, we have the eigenvalues of A square R. We have already seen these and they are repeated twice. Now, what are the eigenvalues of A? That is the question. What is that? That is the question. And root of 1 into 100, root of 2 into 99 and root of 50 into 51, they are certainly the eigenvalues of A. And since the trace of A is equal to 0, even the minus ones, the minus into under the square root of 1 into 100, minus into under the square root of 2 into 99 and so on so forth are also eigenvalues. So therefore the eigenvalues of A are plus or minus square root of 51 into 50 plus or minus square root of 52 into 49 plus or minus square root of 99 into 2 plus or minus 100 into 1. These are the eigenvalues of A. What do we observe? We observe the matrix A, the anti-diagonal matrix of order 100, has 100 distinct eigenvalues. And distinct eigenvalues, that's number one. And we also note down under the square root of 100 into 1, that is 10. 10 is an eigenvalue of A. So let's look at the options. In one of the options, third option is one of the eigenvalues of A is 10. That is true. Therefore, the option 3 is true. And notice that each eigenvalue is less than 51. The highest value of the eigenvalue is under the square root of 51 into 50, which is less than 51. And each one is less than 51. So none of the eigenvalues of A is greater than or equal to 51. Therefore, none of the real eigenvalues of A exceeds 51. That is the option 4, and the option 4 is true. Thus, option 3 is true and option 4 is true. And we've already seen these eigenvalues are all distinct, and A is of order 100, and it has 100 distinct eigenvalues. Therefore, A is diagonalizable. Right. Now, A is diagonalizable since A is of order 100 and it has 100 distinct eigenvalues. Therefore, what do you mean by that? It is diagonalizable. There exists a real matrix S such that S inverse AS is equal to D, where D is the diagonal matrix whose entries are the eigenvalues of A. This is the diagonalization. This is the diagonalization. That means A is similar to D over R. That is, A is similar to a diagonal matrix over R. Whenever A is similar to a diagonal matrix over R, it is also similar to a diagonal matrix over C. So let's look at our options. So A is similar to a diagonal matrix over R, that is the option 1 is true. And A is not similar to a diagonal matrix is not true. Therefore, the option 1 is true and the option 2 is not true. So in all, the final answer is the options 1, 3 and 4 are true. And that is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section Linear Algebra, and the question is based on the eigenvalues of an anti-diagonal matrix of order 100. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on these lines. I wish you all the best. Thank you.